A greenhouse is a world where life blooms, irrespective of the chill in the external world. But what stands between the biting frost and the flourishing green?
Welcome, fellow plant enthusiasts. I'm Trevor with Greenhouse Emporium. And today, we're talking about a fundamental topic that's often overlooked, well, at least until winter rolls in, greenhouse insulation. Now, in this video, we'll unravel the mysteries behind those insulation values for greenhouse kits and unveil just how critical they are in the nurturing of your flourishing plants. We'll answer the questions you frequently get, such as, how does insulation work? What do these insulation values really mean? And most importantly, how can the right insulation make or break the health of your cherished plants? We're about to get into the root of all of those questions. Now let's start with the basics. What is greenhouse insulation? It's a feature that helps maintain a certain temperature and humidity within a greenhouse. While temperature outside can drop drastically sometimes, a well-insulated greenhouse should keep the temperature steady, or the temperature changes will happen slower. You've probably already connected the dots on why this is so critical. Proper insulation is pivotal to plant growth and health. In a less insulated greenhouse, large temperature changes can create stress for plants and therefore reduce growth and yield. Insulation directly affects the microclimate within the greenhouse. It affects temperature and humidity levels, which play vital roles in your plant's growth. Different plants have varied needs, so depending on what you want to grow and what climate you're in, you should give greenhouse insulation a thought before starting your greenhouse garden. So now let's talk numbers. Proper insulation is a game changer for energy efficiency. It helps in reducing the energy consumption of heating and cooling systems, leading to significant savings. You may also need multiple heaters or coolers in a less insulated greenhouse. While a well-insulated greenhouse, you won't need as many. Now, there are initial costs involved in getting a well-insulated greenhouse or installing insulation. However, the return on investment over time is substantial in terms of energy and accessory savings, as well as plant yield due to better greenhouse environment. Let's demystify insulation values. You might find some indicators of insulation values while looking at greenhouse kits or greenhouse coverings. You'll often see them referred to as R values, K values, or U values. Now, R values measure the effectiveness of insulating materials or of insulating capability. A higher value means better insulation. U values represent the thermal transmittance, or in other words, the heat loss. You want a lower number here. R and U values are reciprocal of one another. K values represent the thermal conductivity, in which the capacity of material to conduct heat. A lower value is better in this case as well. Okay, so let's look at some examples so you can understand this a little bit better. A 3 millimeter single pane window has the R value of a 0.95. while it is a 1.89 for 10 millimeter double wall polycarbonate. The U value for a 3 millimeter glass is a 1.05, and it's a 0.53 for that 10 millimeter poly. Now, the U value and the R value are reciprocal, so by knowing one, you can calculate the other, as you can see here on the screen. Now, long story short, all this really tells us is that a 10 millimeter polycarbonate has a better insulating qualities compared to the 3 millimeter glass, because the R value is higher, the U value is lower. Now, if you're still on the fence between glass and polycarbonate, we've made a video about this. We'll put the link over in the corner. But now let's get back to the insulating values at hand. All these numbers might confuse you, but it's a very good indicator when you compare it to more greenhouse glazing types. This table shows you multiple types, and we put them in order from least insulating to the highest insulating, helping you to choose the right insulation for your greenhouse. Well, now that we've spent some time focusing on greenhouse covering material, as it has a great influence on insulation, that's because most heat is lost through the glazing, just like a house with a large amount of windows becomes more vulnerable to heat loss. And in houses, it's just as important to pick a good double pane window as an example. Now, you know, glazing isn't the only factor that insulates a greenhouse. You also have frames that can prevent or enable heat loss. You know, there aren't many greenhouse kits on the market that have insulated frames. You know, most greenhouses have aluminum frames, which enable the transfer of heat or cold quite easily. However, we do have one particular product that is constructed of a composite material that offers a cold barrier for added protection. It's everywhere the outside meets the inside so that it won't transfer heat or the temperature as quickly as the aluminum frames, as you can see right here in the center. Now, you know, a wooden frame may also help with insulation. However, wood can warp or it can change due to humidity. It's also more prone to rot. So aluminum, it's still a lot longer lasting. Now, in addition to the framing, gaskets and seals between glazing and the framework play a massive role. Polycarbonate on aluminum doesn't seal 100%. Therefore, closing these gaps ensure more insulation. Besides, any material will change shape minimally when temperatures change, and seals or gaskets can eliminate that problem as well. So now let's talk about something that most people overlook, greenhouse foundations. The foundation setup can also play a huge role in maintaining the proper greenhouse temperature. I'm going to explain this by using a few examples. However, since this is a bigger topic, we're going to make another video about this. So stay tuned and subscribe to our channel so you won't miss it. For the best insulated foundations, you should dig below the frost line and install a perimeter wall that your greenhouse will sit on. This way, the frost won't creep in from below. Now, let's say you install your greenhouse on a wooden deck. The gaps between the wood will let the air, cool air or hot air, in. This will make it much harder for you to maintain a certain temperature. So, the foundation can also play a very significant role in greenhouse insulation. Whether or not these things are relevant to you really depends on your personal situation. Do you really need this much insulation? That's a question that only you can answer. You should consider your local climate, what you want to grow, and your budget, because these things will answer those questions for you. If you have a mild winter year-round, you probably are fine with less insulation. If you have harsh winters and you want to grow warm season crops in the cold season, you might want to consider a well-insulated greenhouse, especially if your electric costs are high. Now, if you're on a tighter budget, but you need more insulation, there's still a few things you can do to insulate your greenhouse for better performance. For example, you can insulate any gaps or cracks. You can also insulate the north-facing wall with horticultural bubble wrap or with insulating materials. You can add thermal mass to maintain a steadier temperature between daytime and nighttime. You know, adding horticultural bubble wrap on the walls and the horticultural fleece around plants can keep them cozy. Using compost as a natural heat source. Now, if we went into detail, because there's many more things to discuss, that would tend to stretch this video out. So we'll actually discuss that in later videos. So stay tuned and be sure to subscribe. We hope this video about greenhouse insulation helped you understand the critical role it plays in fostering a thriving environment for your plants. If you found this information to be helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and share your thoughts or your questions in the comments below. Your insight can be the seed for new learning and discussions within the community. I'm Trevor with Greenhouse Emporium, and thank you for watching.